Gemma, and we were going to answer some questions that you guys posted, and at the end of the video we're gonna do a giveaway. So we got a lot of questions, like more than 1,000, and it was very difficult to choose. So I'm sorry if I didn't choose your question. You can email it to me, I'll try to answer. And so let's start. Did you have other pugs or dogs before Mochi? Yeah, I used to have a dog named Taka. He was an English sheepdog and he was super awesome. He was my best friend and he lived up to 13 years. So that's it. But not pugs, Mochi is the first pug. How old is Mochi? This is my favorite account on Insta. Thank you. And this question I'm very happy to answer because apparently everyone wants to know how old is Mochi. I got that question like a million times and I get asked this every day. So Mochi's 4. He's turning 5 in August 10th. August 11th. I'm August 10th, he's August 11th. Okay, ¿cuándo es el cumpleaños de Mochi? ¿Le gusta que se lo celebren? I just answered that. I don't know, the question is, when is Mochi's birthday and does he like to celebrate? His birthday is August 11th, one day after mine, so we usually celebrate together. And this year he's turning 5, so I really want to do a big party and everyone will be invited, so hopefully we can get to do it. Did you always want a pug or did Mochi just steal your heart? I always wanted a pug. At first I didn't know pugs existed, so one day I met a friend's pug and I was like, hello, what is this? Her name was Klein, and I was a teenager when I met her and I was like, what's that? Like, it was so cool, she was so cute and it was like nothing I've ever seen. I don't know, she stole my heart. Like, after that I was pug obsessed. Where do you leave Mochi when you are out of the city? I always take Mochi with me and I've only left him with my parents or Feli's parents because I'm a horrible mom and I don't trust anyone with him. Is there any secret downsides to owning a pug? Actually, yeah, there are many downsides. One is that they are very delicate. They are high maintenance, like you really need to clean up his wrinkle every day and brush his teeth, because some other dogs are better with teeth because they like chewing and then the teeth get clean a little bit, but pugs don't, so you really need to brush his teeth. And they get eyes problems, ear problems, breathing problems, so yeah, they are very expensive because you're gonna go to the vet a lot. Like, we go, like, Mochi's perfectly healthy. He's tired, but he's perfectly healthy, and we go to the vet every other month, like, just because it's always like a little infection, a little whatever. But and the other thing is that they have like their breathing problem is very bad, and he gets like he has a very hard time in summer. So yeah, that's very bad. It's very scary. Okay, next. ¿Cómo fue el cambio de país para Mochi? Se adaptó bien. Saludos desde Girona. It's funny because Mochi is actually from Girona. Actually, Mochi loved the change of country because we used to live in Barcelona and our area didn't have like a very nice park. And when we moved to New York, we lived right on the Upper West Side, which had like we were actually between the Riverside Park and Central Park, and we used to go to the Riverside Park. And it was beautiful, he had a lot of friends, the park was amazing, so yeah, Mochi had a blast. And he made friends with someone who worked in a restaurant close to our home. So every time we walked by the restaurant, the guy went out and gave Mochi bacon. So yeah, Mochi loved it. ¿Alguna vez han reconocido a Mochi en la calle como celebridad? Has Mochi ever been spotted in the street as a celebrity? Actually, yes, and many times. One was very funny because it was caught on camera, so I'll try to put it here. And because I was like doing a story.
Ay, sí, es Mochi.
Sí,
eres Gemma, ¿verdad?
Sí, hola.
Hola, sí, no necesito colores de la River.
Sí, sí, sí.
But the first time, it was unreal for us. We were in an airport. Usually, when we're in an airport, people usually spot us. Like, we've been spotted many times. But for the first time, it was crazy because I was talking to a flight attendant, like waiting for the flight, and someone said, "Gemma?" And I turned around and it's a woman I don't know. And she was like, "Oh, I'm Jessica Ara, and I follow you on Instagram." And actually, since she comments a lot, I totally knew who she was. And it was very funny. And she was actually wearing Mochi's phone cover, so well, it was very sweet. And after that, we became friends. And Mochi loved her dog. She has a beautiful pug named Zelda. I posted about her, and yeah, Mochi is in love. Okay, next. Amo a Mochi. Es muy hermoso el remolón. ¿Cómo manejas el tema de los pelos en la ropa? I love Mochi. He's super cute. And how do you deal with hair in the clothes? Yeah, I get asked that a lot, like if Mochi sheds. Yeah, Mochi sheds like crazy, like unreal. But I don't care. The way I deal with it is I just don't care. Every time my mom sees me, she gets crazy. She's like, "No, you, Gemma, look, really, you can leave the house like this. You can leave the house like this." And she gets me a lot of rolls, that rolls that you put on the clothes and then the hair is supposed to come out. And I never use them, so I have tons of them at home. But really, because I really don't care. I don't care. Is there any book or publication available of Mochi's life? I would like to read more about his stories and take a look at the first ones that I haven't read. I love Mochi. There's no book yet, but I'm working on it, and it's gonna be a recopilation of some of the cartoons I've posted online, but then I added some longer versions of some specific cartoons, and then I'm adding new cartoons that they are only gonna leave in the book. So I'm very excited about it. Hopefully it's gonna come up eventually, and so hopefully it's gonna happen. ¿Cuántas horas al día duerme Mochi? How many hours a day does Mochi sleep? Well, a lot. As you can see, Mochi is a very relaxed pug, and he sleeps, and I'm not kidding, about 22 hours. And he got a blood test not so long ago, so I know he's healthy, but obviously he's just very tired from looking cute all day. Okay, next. What is the best thing about drawing art to you? Why do you love it? Was it hard to make it a career? What do you recommend to people that want to start a career as a comic artist? Lots of love from Venezuela. For me, the best thing about art is that I'm very bad at speaking, if you haven't noticed, and at writing, if you haven't noticed. And for me, art was always a way to communicate myself because it was like easy for me. You make a drawing, you're playing what you're feeling or what you're thinking, and that's it. So it was easier for me than putting my thoughts into words, and so that's why I love it. And to make it a career, it's so much fun. I'm actually an architect, and architecture is beautiful, but working as an artist is much fun than working as an architect. And what do you recommend people who want to start a career as a comic artist? Just do it. Draw every day, and the first 100 drawings are gonna be terrible, but then eventually they're gonna get better. So I think that's the best thing you can do. Does Mochi know his commands in any other language besides Spanish? Actually, Mochi only understands Catalan. Catalan is a language spoken in one region of Spain, and he only learned a little bit of English because the super in our past apartment, sorry, Billy is texting me, the super in our previous apartment was in love with him, and he gave him a lot of treats, and he learned English just to communicate with him. Okay. If Mochi could speak, what kind of voice do you think he would have? What actor or actress would voice him in a cartoon? Mochi, do you want to talk?
No.
Oh, there you go. ¿Echas de menos tener proyectos artísticos más elaborados que las viñetas de Mochi? Do you miss doing artistic projects more elaborate than Mochi's cartoons? Actually, I don't, because I do visual art as well, and you can check it on my Instagram or Facebook. And yeah, I do painting and drawing, so, and it's very different from my cartoons. It's very like, it's realistic and it's very intricate, it has a lot of work, so it's very different. How did you get started drawing Mochi and realizing people like your drawings? Was it a random hobby that took off, or were you an artist before? It was a random hobby that took off. As I told you, I'm an architect, so I was working in an architecture firm, and on my subway commute, I would draw about Mochi. Like, I did something I've always done, like I've done cartoons about my life in general, like ever since I was a little girl. But I miss Mochi so much during the day, even though Mochi was with Feli, so he wasn't alone, but I miss him. So I would draw about him, and I posted on Instagram, and a lot of people relate to it, because what I thought it was very special of Mochi, apparently it's very common in many dogs, so people really relate to the drawings, and that's why it took off. Has the vet ever told you that Mochi needs to lose weight? Actually, no. I know I've made many cartoons about the vet telling Mochi that he's fat, but actually Mochi is in his right way for a male. And yeah, he's healthy. Actually, last time we went to the vet said he was very healthy, so very happy. Also, he said that if he lost a little bit of weight before summer, it wouldn't be the worst thing. But, after all, healthy. Will you ever animate your comics? Because I think they look amazing if you do.
Yeah.
No, I've never animated. I have no idea how to animate, but I would love to see the cartoons on animated. Because for me, the cartoons move and then I just draw like a picture, but in my mind they move, so yeah, I will love, and I love animation, so hopefully one day. What's the weirdest but cutest thing Mochi has ever done? There's a few. I think I'll choose two. One, and it was super cute, when he was a puppy, and he was around 4 months old, we were like in the snow, and there was an area that it was very slippery, and I kept slipping all the time, and Mochi, he wants to leave the nest. I don't know if you see him now, but he's watching.
Mochi!
So, do you remember when you were a teeny tiny puppy and we were in the snow and it was slippery and my boots kept slipping, and what did you do? Do you remember, Mochi? So, what he did was he kept like grabbing my boots so I wouldn't slip. So, how cute is that? And he was like teeny tiny, and he was wearing a blue jacket. I'm gonna try to find a photo. And also, he did something very cute and very weird.
Amor, mira que amor.
And another thing that he did, when he was very young, he wasn't allowed on the bed because he peed. Oh yeah.
Tal vez.
So yeah, he wasn't allowed on the bed because he would pee on it. And what he did one day, that we were switching clothes from summer to winter or whatever, and there were a lot of clothes everywhere. So he created, like, he would grab the clothes and he created like a ramp to get on the bed, like to walk through the ramp and get on the bed. And I thought that was super weird and cute. My little engineer. ¿Cómo haces para que Mochi sea tan tranquilo? Mi pack se llama Ringo y es un terremoto. Saludos desde Ecuador. How do you do it? So Mochi is so relaxed. My Ringo is like an earthquake. Hi from Ecuador. I don't know. He came this way. Like I don't know why, but he's so laid back. So yeah, I don't know. One tip of advice: when dogs are very like active, the best thing you can do is get them tired. If you walk them a lot and they can run off leash, like in a safe area or a dog park or whatever, and you get them to get tired every day, you will see how more relaxed they are. But some dogs take hours to get tired, so it really depends on the dog. Okay. In any ways, did Mochi change you at all? Yeah, massively. I'm very anxious and nervous and active, and then Mochi is super calm. He's a calm presence in my life. So I really, like, he really helped me take things slower. And by the way, I've always had like the worst insomnia, the worst. Like ever since I was a little kid, I could never ever sleep. And when I was in architecture school, I would work all night until 10 a.m. or noon for the day after, and I would go to bed and even couldn't sleep. And ever since I got Mochi, I slept every day, like no problem. Okay. Si no te dedicaras al mundo del arte, ¿a qué te gustaría dedicarte? Un abrazo enorme para los dos. If you didn't do art, what would you like to do? A hug for the two of you. I should say an architect because it's what I am. But if I could really choose, I would love to be a surgeon, a plastic surgeon, because it's, I love doctors. I come from a family of doctors, and I think medicine is great. However, I don't have the memory to memorize all the things, so it's not for me. But if I could choose, I would love to be a doctor, and more specifically a plastic surgeon, because it's very artistic and I think it's so much fun. Oh, and that was the last question. So let's go to do the giveaway. Yay! Thank you so much for your questions.
Your cartoons are so familiar, it's wonderful.
My wee Polly didn't like the rain. It made her tail go straight and ears flat. Does the rain make Mochi's tail go straight? Definitely. Mochi hates the rain so much. Okay, and last but not least, the original drawing. We go to Valentina, por favor. I have at least two questions. Where are you from and what brought you to New York? And also, what are your adventures with Mochi going to end up in a book anytime soon? So, we are originally from Barcelona, Spain, and we moved to New York because I was accepted to do a master's at Columbia University. And what else? And I'm gonna put the adventures in the book, I already said so, but yeah, I hope so. Hopefully. Fingers crossed. So, congratulations to the winners. I wish I could give you a present for all of you. And this video was super long, so I will probably do a second video with some of the questions. Thank you so much for watching. Mochi. Well, this person, Mochi wanted to choose this person, so I'm gonna do something special for this one. Who is I Bar? Is there anything big you would like to achieve in life? Yeah, many things. Many things. The book is gonna be big. Hopefully turning the cartoon into animation is gonna be big too, and I would love that. And I don't know, many other things. So yeah, Ibar, you're gonna get a little present too because Mochi chose you. And that's it.